I arrived in 1961 to take a single course. I was going on into the graduate program at Johns Hopkins. The summer course was listed as having F.G. Walton Smith as the teacher. And though we didn't have all the internet and everything that we have now, you could do all sorts of research, and I found out, wow, this is a great, great guy. I made arrangements to come down just for the summer course. Instead of the person who walked in to start the course was a young man who said, I am not F.G. Walton Smith. I went, oh, I got that. And, and it turned out that 4 years later, I married him. And that's Gilbert Voss, my late husband, who was the original director of the museum, the first director of the museum. This is the museum. It's very crowded. It is the largest set of collections for the tropical Atlantic or in the world. The museum was originally started back in the late 30s. It starts off with the order of classification, increased complexity and relationship of the shrimp, the lobsters, hermit crabs at the very end, sea urchins, starfish, and so forth, which are on that side. And see the wonderful diversity of form in corals. Some of them are so large that we couldn't put them in cabinets, like exceptionally large there. The specialty of both my husband's and mine were cephalopods. We had the liberty to give more space to the cephalopod collection. Now our cephalopod collection is worldwide. The other collections are almost 100% tropical Atlantic. All of these tags, every one of these tags is a species. So you can see just the speciose nature of the collections, accompanied by data as far as their depths, where they came from. Now when you see blue tags, these blue tags on the bottles, now those are paratypes from the new species that were described from this collection. We've had over 600 new species described from our material. Dr. Gilbert Grosvenor was the first full-time editor of the National Geographic, and he was in and out of our office in the Anastasia building, so he encouraged us to write up a proposal looking at the entire tropical Atlantic, including the Caribbean and, of course, of Florida up to Bermuda. It's work that can never be duplicated. The maps are showing various expeditions that we have taken, the dates and so forth, study of the Virgin Isles, and then go big deeps in the north of Puerto Rico, Dominican Republic, with a National Geographic flag over the top because of their support of our work. And all of these sites are from the surface to the bottom with multiple gears. And we're talking about, whether we're talking about bottom brabs or we're talking about nets with 40-foot mouths. Now with some of these countries, we maintain very close interaction with their biodiversity projects. We did have an early collaboration with Cuba, with the marine researchers at the University of Havana. They have some of the greatest untouched coral reefs in the whole Caribbean area. And so we have to be extremely careful in not, you know, have a big tourist coming in and them ruining that area. It's very important to know what's there and environmental protection of the area. There are many ways, many areas that have changed over the years. The funding for this type of work, the morphological work, the morphology of the species, this is where we have changed, I have changed, the museum has changed, into close collaboration with the geneticists. None of these collections can ever be duplicated, but I don't have time to do my personal research anymore, just maintaining these collections. It just goes on and on, you know, there's always more and more and more to be done. But, you know, times change, and since and you have to, you know, go with it and adapt, but not lose the importance. And that is what I have done with the museum. Is a museum. People would love, other institutions would love to have the museum here. There's no question about the importance of this museum to the school. I guess I'm so intimate with the collections and time and so forth that I just see it's you know, this is an essential part of my life. And it's a challenge. And I love challenges.